This is the main antenna on the complex. It's called the Intercomplex Radio Communication System, or the IRCS. IRCS operates on 9 frequencies simultaneously and has a special channel called the PAS, the Primary Alerting System, that actually carried the order to launch. The crew could use this antenna to talk to the other 17 sites around Tucson and the wing command post. The system provides secure data and voice communication for the crew. This antenna is regarded as being soft, which means that it would easily be destroyed in a nearby nuclear detonation. But this is a really important system, and so to ensure that it would continue to function even after a nuclear strike, it has 2 identical backup antennas. These antennas are hardened and kept in their own underground silos. This is what they look like in the stowed position, and this is what they look like after they've been deployed. With the press of a button in the control center, the lid pops open, and the antenna is literally pushed up from underground by pressurized gas. It's like a piston. This small antenna is for the UHF radio system. Day to day, the crew could use this to talk to helicopters flying to or from the site with VIPs or security people or maybe spare parts. During wartime, this antenna could be used to listen for the airborne command post, an airplane called Looking Glass. Looking Glass flew 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. They were ready to send the order to launch if ground-based command posts were destroyed. The large antenna near the parking lot is a shortwave radio antenna that provided the crew with worldwide communications if they ever needed that. But in the 25-year history of the program, they never really needed that. So it didn't get used much at all, except to receive time signals they used to set the clock down in the control center. That big antenna, of course, is a soft antenna, meaning that it would easily be destroyed. And so it has a hardened backup out there in the far corner of the complex. This is a telescoping antenna that covers the same frequency bands as the big antenna in the parking lot, except that it can be stored underground when it's not needed. They can raise and lower it to almost any length from 7.5 feet up to about 117 feet, depending on the frequency in use. The big antenna near the parking lot is officially called a disc cage, and it still works. Amateur radio operators are invited to use the antenna during normal business hours at no charge. The final antenna on the complex is called the SLIFX antenna. SLIFX stands for Survivable Low Frequency Communication System. The actual antenna is buried underground directly beneath the antenna that you see on display. The display antenna was salvaged from another site here in town and installed so that you could see what it looks like. SLIFX operates on very low radio frequencies, between 14 and 60 kilohertz, and it can only be used to listen for messages. The crew couldn't send any messages with this system. Messages were in digital form and were printed on a narrow strip of paper, like a cash register receipt. All of these radio systems had one basic function, and that was to make sure that the crew could get the order to launch no matter what.